Hi all, welcome back. Today I'm sharing two recipes using banana. One is banana bhajji, another is banana chips. Both are quite popular street foods. I'm going to start by peeling a raw banana here. Whatever you want to make out of the banana, make sure you follow the same process, that is after you peel and cut in the desired shape, you have to soak it in water until you cook it, otherwise the banana is going to turn black. So here I am cutting it to the desired shape that we use for bhajji and I am soaking in water. Now here I am sharing a small secret I learned from the bhajji bonde owner near my house. She adds a small onion, few pieces of ginger and two green chilies and makes a paste. This paste adds amazing flavor to the banana bhajjis. I am going to grind this into a smooth paste. I have taken around 1 cup of besan and into this I am going to add the onion, ginger and green chili paste. And also going to add 1/2 spoon of turmeric powder, and since we have already added chili, I'm going to just add 1/2 spoon of red chili powder, 1 spoon of coriander powder, and whenever I'm frying something, I like to add carom seeds or ajwain to help in digestion. Now I'm going to add around 1/2 cup of water, but I'm going to add water little. So I used around 1/2 glass of water to make batter which is runny like this. Now mix it nicely and I'm going to add little salt and a pinch of baking soda as well. Now give it a good mix. Well, now the batter is ready. Our next step is frying the bhajjis. For this I'm going to take the slices which I have soaked in water and dip it into the batter. You're going to coat the slices nicely. That is the reason why the batter is a little thick, because the bhajjis are slant in the surface, that's why. Now I'm going to fry them in hot oil. I'm just going to fry it for 1 minute until the bhajjis are nicely puffed and golden brown and cooked from all the sides. Now drain the oil nicely and serve it hot. My kids love to savour this with green chutney or even tomato ketchup. So that was my first recipe. The next recipe, please keep watching. So the next recipe is my favorite. I literally danced after making this recipe because I was so happy. Banana chips are my all-time favorite, and indulging in guilt-free banana chips with very less oil is my dream. So here I have followed the same process. I have sliced the banana in circle shape and I have soaked it until I am going to use it. Now this is my own recipe. Here I have taken around 2 tablespoons coconut oil, added just a pinch of salt and a pinch of turmeric powder to give it a nice yellow color. I'm going to mix it nicely. Now I am going to take the slices of banana after draining the water and mix the oil thoroughly throughout. Add the oil and nicely mix it. And make sure that all of the pieces get coated with the oil finally. Once I am done with that, I am going to start cooking it in the air fryer. As I have mentioned already, whenever I am using air fryer, I preheat it for 3 minutes at least. And it is ideal, whenever you want to cook anything in air fryer, you have to preheat it. So I am going to layer the bananas in one layer and I'm going to cook it for 7 minutes. 7 minutes was enough and the chips turned out so well, so crunchy, so crispy. I literally danced and enjoyed while having this. So that's it for now. I hope you enjoyed both the recipes. Thank you for watching. Bye guys.